Hey guys, what is up? Orange Gamer here, and I am doing my first episode of my career mode for UFC. So right now I'm just going to customize him and we'll see what he turns out to be. I decided to make him look like me in real life because I bet there's a lot of other people that made him look like Conor McGregor, and I kind of want to be original. So, but I just wanted to say on my other video of UFC, I made a mistake and I said that Anderson Silva was African American. He is actually Brazilian. I'm sorry that I made that mistake. It was a very, very bad mistake and I'm sorry. But otherwise, I think for the most part, people liked it. For the nickname, let's see what there is. Boom Boom. Clubber, Comeback Kid, Dynamite, El Diablo, Ferocious, Haymaker, Haymaker from the Black Ops 3. Magic Man, I kind of like that one. Mystery, Napalm, Primetime, I like Primetime. Alright. And if you guys don't know, I live in Iowa, so I'm gonna see if they have Des Moines, Iowa. And if they do, that's where he's gonna be from. Yep, here it is. All right. Age, I'm gonna make him 20. Featherweight, I like featherweight division. We'll make him 5'10" and 143. All right, now that we got that out, we can go to appearance. Wow, these are not very good haircuts. Eh, I'll take that. Oh, wow, that is a lot of hair. Eyebrows. Let's go to eyebrows. Yeah, that looks pretty much. Hair color, head. Yeah, that looks about right. Eyebrows, red. Now, in real life, I am one of the whitest kids you have ever seen. So when we get to skin tone, I'm gonna change myself to really white because I am definitely not this tan. All right, I like that. Skin tone. Yep, that looks about me. Maybe a little bit whiter. Tattoos, let's see. Let's have a big one on the chest. Are you kidding? A chicken? Come on. Ooh, this looks cool. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Then we're gonna have one on his leg. Where is it? Oh, I think it's on his pants. All right. So, I think that's it. Let's go to gear. Walkout gear, shirts. Not sponsored by any of those guys. Accessories. Ankle brace. Entrance music. All right, I think we'll go with that one. Skills, attributes. All right. So, I think he's going to be. Let's do kickboxing. Right, I like kickboxing. Kickboxing's good. All right, now I'm just gonna go back and see if I missed anything. I think I got it all for the most part. Alright. I like that quote. Forrest Griffin was a great fighter. He was actually the winner of The Ultimate Fighter Season 1, and he was actually a really funny guy. He was really good in the octagon, too. Alright, I'm gonna skip. Alright. Very nice, very nice. Hey man, my name is Mike Dallas. I work a lot with fighters in the UFC. They're doing some scouting for the next season of the Ultimate Fighter reality show today. We're gonna work on some basic stand-up techniques to start off. Just follow the instructions and do your best. Mike Dallas. So right now we're gonna do some training. And it's kind of fun. But at the same time it gets kind of boring. So, the fight, right now I am recording on Saturday, and so I'm super excited for the fight between Conor McGregor and Jose Aldo. If you watch my other UFC video, you know that they were supposed to fight, back in July, but Jose Aldo pulled out, so it's been like a 6 month wait, or like a 5 month wait, which has been like really, really, really painful on me, because I had been looking forward to that fight, because at that time I was just getting into UFC, but I had known about it, and that really sparked my interest, and I was like, wow, this is going to be my first fight. So it looks like we're going to be doing leg kicks now.
Nice work with the leg kicks.
I think I did kickboxing, so my kick should be powerful. So I'll be doing that a lot in my fights. And what it is, the Ultimate Fighter, is where you get together with a bunch of other people and you kind of room with them. And then you get to fight against them, and whoever wins will be able to go and sign a contract with the UFC. And then you get to fight in the UFC, which is like really, really big. And so after you get signed into the UFC, you're going to want to do some stuff, like get better, obviously. I don't know why I said that. But you're going to want to be able to win and to get to the top so you can be the main card and the main fight between all the other people. And you want to be the best. You want to try to get to the top of your division. And you want to just try to defend your title as much as you can. So, I don't know how long the series is going to go on for. Probably 10 episodes, maybe, tops. Something like that. But we'll see how well it's liked. And I know that a lot of people are critical or very, I don't know the word. They're very specific about UFC. So, if I make a mistake, make sure that you correct me, but don't be a jerk about it. Nice work, man. Now we're going to take a step into the octagon for a quick round of stand-up sparring. Put it all together, movement, offense, and defense. Let's see what you can do. I'm ready. I'm ready for this. First time in the octagon. Let's go. Even though we're just sparring. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Ooh. Ooh, ooh. And the really funny part is you can't, you can't knock out your trainer. So it gets kind of annoying because you'll just be beating him, and then he'll get like two or three solid punches. Oh! Wow, that was very, very good, I guess. We haven't worked on ground game, so I can't punch, so that's kind of stupid. That's so dumb. I can't believe, because I think I could have knocked him out if I had him on the ground, but since my guy hasn't learned anything about ground game and like punching on the ground, it wasn't going to work. So, you know, that's kind of dumb, but whatever. I'll be able to destroy him next time. But that was like really good in the beginning. I just came out with a few punches. And I think I knocked him down. I think I would have knocked him out. I don't know. Who knows? And I have, oh boy, and I have this on the hardest setting, so it is going to be hard, and I am probably going to, wow, that was an amazing combo, and so I am probably going to be losing, I don't know how much, but, man, I don't know how much I'm going to be losing, but it will probably be quite a lot due to the fact that it is on the hardest setting, but I may win, who knows. Alright, nice. Nice sparring session. Posture up in the dominant ground position. This will add more power to your ground strikes. Yes, it will. Ground and pound, baby. Good stuff. Okay, now we're going to work on some drills in the clinch and make sure you know how to handle yourself in that position. Remember, just follow the instructions and do your best. Mike Dulles. Or Dulles, I don't know. I don't really care for the clinch. I always try to get out of it. But, I mean, other people seem to like it. I don't know. I prefer to be standing up when I fight, not in the clinch or on the ground. But on the ground, I'm okay. But I definitely cannot pull off a submission. Submissions are really hard. Especially on the hardest setting. That was pretty easy. Ooh, these are brutal. These could easily damage any part of your body. Ah, messed up.
Work the position. Nice job. Keep going.
And then also at UFC 194, they're doing Luke Rockhold versus Chris Weidman for the title championship. And that should also be a really good fight too, because I don't really follow that weight division, but I've heard it's been all hype for that fight. Like, a lot of people are just going to it for that fight. Like, they don't even care about the McGregor-Aldo fight. But that's the fight. That's the reason why I'm going to it. Great work, man. Now, same thing as before. Let's do a quick sparring round, but focus on fighting in the clinch. Work some transitions, land some strikes, and break away. Keep working until the round ends. Nice. Alright, second sparring sesh. Let's go. That's a good George St. Pierre quote. Alright, here we go, pregame hype, let's go, alright, got him in the clinch, transition, let's go. Oof, ooh, he's getting a little feisty. Come on, no, oof, pull out. Oh, you can't even throw punches, I guess you're just totally supposed to be in the clinch. Want adjust. Get away. Come on. No. Won't even let you block. Alright, I'm gonna try transition. Stop hitting me in the leg. No. This guy looks like he's like sucking my head off. I think I just saw a groin shot. That's a penalty. Gotta be kidding me. I'm trying to keep my distance for the rest of the fight. No! Come Half a minute. Push, push, push. Alright. I think I'm just going to try to... How is he going so fast and I'm going so slow? Alright. Let's go in. Struck like a cobra. That's not the noise a cobra makes. I'm so silly. Alright. Well, I'm getting kind of... Oh, yeah. Here we go. Nope. That was a bad one. Okay, so not a very good spar sesh, but that's okay. That's fine. I'm okay with that. Alright, let's move on. We're going to drill some basic techniques on the ground, some wrestling and jiu-jitsu stuff. Same as before, just follow the instructions and do your best. Alright.
Takedown, that's gonna be our key today. What we need to do is move forward, use feints, get on the inside.
Strike like a tiger. This is really dumb because all you do is you just tackle him. And then you just press L3 to get back up. That's all you do.
There we go. Keep driving. Perfect. Great job on those takedowns. Nobody can stop you. Submission defense. That's the goal for today.
I'm probably going to divide this up into a small or a bigger video. Divide this up into smaller videos because this has gone on for quite a while. I don't know if you guys like longer videos or not. But I know that I kind of like longer videos, like 10-minute videos. But that's all personal opinion. Oh man. My guy's a baby. Okay, I told you I wasn't good at submissions. So, hold the R1 and R1 to attempt a submission. Alright, here we go.
Don't stop till you hear it pop.
Alright, keep it up. Alright, we got this. I think we got this. We're pulling it through. This looks so painful right now. Let's go. Let's go. Hope your arms hurts, you baby.
Beautiful work today. Love what you're doing with these submissions.
Oh yeah, black belt. Let's go. You're gonna be at the top of the division in no time. Good work. Okay, let's do one more quick sparring round and focus on fighting on the ground. You need to be able to handle yourself in these situations, so let's see what you've got. Martial arts isn't about size and strength, it's about skill, technique, and the will to win. BJ Penn. Alright, hopefully this won't be like the other one. Takedown! Oh. Let's go for a submission just straight out. Transition. Maybe if we just transition a little bit. I'm gonna try to pull off an armbar.
Improved position. Get the half guard and pound away.
Come on. This guy is being a gigantic poopy. Ah! Oh, no. Alright. And now he's probably not going to let me get off. Oh, nice. You can throw punches on this one. Alright, I think I'll just beat him up standing up. No, you don't. Yes, he did. He did. Ugh, single leg takedown. Ooh, ground and pound on here is just like so beautiful. It just makes me want to cry because you just destroy with that. Oh, he got me.
Push off and get up. Let's go. Kick. 30 seconds left.
Man, this guy's... he's going at it. He must not like me. He must be still mad about the submission I put him in. That axe kick. I hate axe kicks on this game. They're way too slow and they can easily be deflected. Man. Alright, takedown. Oof. That gave me some serious... no, no, no. Get wrecked, mate. Alright guys, I think that's pretty much going to end it for this episode. I know that it was a longer one, and I don't think that the other videos will be that long. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll be doing a video on a review of UFC 194, things that I liked and things that could have been better. I don't think that there could have been anything better, because that was an amazing one. But yeah, make sure you tell all your family, friends, and maybe your cousins, too. Alright, thank you for watching, and this is Orange Gamer.